Let's solve this trig equation. We have sine of 2 theta that's equal to cosine of theta. What shall we do? Well, we have 2 theta here, right? And this is only theta, so that's no good. But this is 2 theta instead of the sine. We do have the double angle formula for sine, right? So let's use that. This is the same as what? 2 sine theta times cosine theta, right? We have to make sure all the angles are the same in the trig equation in order to proceed. So this is what we can do at the moment. But then as you can see, this equation involves both sine and cosine, right? Well, I'm just going to subtract cosine theta on both sides, because that way the right hand side will be 0, and then this term has cosine theta, and then right here we can factor out the cosine theta. Nice things will happen. Let me show you. So right here, let me just subtract cosine theta on both sides. This and that will cancel. On the left hand side, we will have 2 sine theta, cosine theta, right? So this one, and then minus cosine theta, and this is equal to 0. Okay, as you can see, this term has the cosine theta, and then this term also has the cosine theta, so let's factor that out. We will factor out the cosine theta, and then what's the remaining things? The first term will just have 2 sine theta left, right? And then that's minus, this is out already, so we do have a 1 left. So this is the factoring. We have sine theta times this quantity, 2 sine theta minus 1, altogether is equal to 0. And now what? We have two factors that's multiplying, it's equal to 0. That means we have cosine theta equal to 0, and then we have to focus on that. And then second of all, we have to focus on this part equals to 0. So let's put it down individually. Let's put down the first one right here. Cosine theta is equal to 0. And then the other one here, we have the 2 sine theta minus 1 equals to 0. So we just have to work them out individually. For this one, you can just tell me cosine of one angle is equal to 0. Right? If you remember all the unit circles and things like that, you can just put down the answer right away, right? However, let's do this real quick. So it's a unit circle. This is a special number. When you have 0 or 1, it's always on the x or y axis. In this case, because we're talking about cosine, this is the x value. If you look at the unit circle, the x values are 0, it's going to be right here and right here, right? Because this point here is 0, 1, and this point here is 0, negative 1. Well, cosine is the x value. Cosine of what angle will end up to be 0? This right here is what? Pi over 2, right? That's the 90 degrees from here to here, 90 degrees. We know cosine of pi over 2. This is equal to 0. First answer, pi over 2. And let me just write it down right here. Theta is equal to pi over 2. I'm just putting down the angle though, but then I just want to show you cosine of pi over 2 will end up to be 0. Well, we have another possibility right here. This. The x value is also 0, but then cosine of what angle we are talking about? This is pi over 2, this is pi, this is 3 pi over 2, right? So cosine of 3 pi over 2, this will also give us 0. And you see, I'm counting this way, I'm not rotating this way, because the question wants us to have the theta value going from 0 to 2 pi, not including the 2 pi, okay? So that's why we only talk about the positive direction right here. 3 pi over 2, that's the second answer. Okay, that's all for this picture here, and now let's move on here. Let's add one on both sides. So we are talking about 2 sine theta is equal to positive 1, and then divide both sides by 2, we are talking about sine theta is equal to 1 over 2. And now what? Okay, sine theta, sine is y over r, and then let's utilize the x and y axis. Notice that we have a positive 1 half, so that means the y has to be positive 1, right? So we'll just draw a triangle like this. This is 1, so it's positive 1 going up, and then the r is 2, so that means the hypotenuse of this triangle is 2. And if you look at this picture, you see that This is a 30-60-90 special right triangle with this side to be square root of 3. But then, all I want is this angle here, and this angle will tell me the answer right away, because it happens to be from the positive angle to this side right away, right? What's this angle? This is a smaller angle in the 30-60-90, this is 30 degrees. But then, in radians, this is what? Pi over 6. So, another answer right here, pi over 6. Can we draw another triangle based on this information? Yes, y is 1, that means I can also have the 1 right here, positive 1 going up, right? R is 2, so I can have the hypotenuse like this, and it's never negative, so it's just like this. However, this side is going to be technically negative square root of 3, but then don't let this bother you too much. You just have to remember, we worry about the angle at the moment. This right here is, once again, pi over 6. But then, how do we get the answer that we want? Going from here, the positive x-axis, right? Going from the positive x-axis, and then you count, like rotate to here. We know the whole thing is pi, but then I don't want to have this pi over 6 right here, so we do pi minus pi over 6. So how do we do this? This is like 6 over 6 minus 1 over 6. So we have 5 over 6, and we can put a pi on the top, and that's the last answer, 5 pi over 6. So we have these four answers right here with my three markers in hand. That's it.